Hi everybody, welcome to the science labs at the Nature Museum. My name is Rebecca and today we're learning about Blandings turtles. We care about Blandings turtles because they are endangered in Illinois, so we're going to take a behind the scenes look at some of the work our biologists do to help these turtles out. We're here at our Blandings turtle lab. Inside of this lab is where our biologists take care of many baby Blandings turtles. Let's go inside. These baby Blandings turtles are part of a conservation program with the Forest Preserve District of DuPage County. We take care of the baby Blandings here at the Nature Museum for up to 2 years. Once they're large enough, they get released back into the wild into DuPage County. Blandings turtles are semi-aquatic, so they need a mix of water and dry areas with plants. The habitat we've created in the Blandings lab is very similar to where they would live in the wild. Baby Blandings turtles are very small and their shells are pretty soft. These baby Blandings turtles are only a few inches long. This means that they're an easy snack for predators like foxes, coyotes, and raccoons. By being raised at the Nature Museum, we're able to protect them from predators. We also give them a varied diet of lots of protein, such as insects and larvae, fish, superworms, mealworms, earthworms, and crayfish. They're able to grow larger and stronger after being raised here at the museum than they would on their own. There is also reduced competition for food at the museum since we make sure each baby Blandings turtle has enough to eat. What are some things you notice about our baby Blandings turtles? Let's go see how big an adult Blandings turtle can get. I'm here with Bob, the adult Blandings turtle. As you can see, he's a bit bigger than the baby Blandings turtles that we saw in the lab. A unique feature of Blandings turtles, and one way that we can identify them, is by looking at their Blandings turtle smile. So if you look closely at his mouth, you can see it almost looks like he's smiling. So Bob is a turtle we have at the museum for education. He's very used to doing programs and being handled. We can't release him into the wild. However, we can learn a lot about him by watching him and sharing him with all of our guests. Let's take a closer look at Bob. Since Bob spends so much time swimming around, what do you think he likes to eat? Fish. Blandings turtles are predators, so they are very good at hunting their food. Bob is pretty good at chasing down fish to eat them. Blandings turtles are also omnivores. What does this mean? It means they do eat other animals, but they can also eat plants. Bob loves to eat worms, crayfish, crickets, and other bugs. While they're babies, they mostly eat meat, but adults like Bob will eat aquatic plants and algae too. Do you notice the patterns and colors on his shell? Why do you think he looks like this? We can see Bob pretty easily on this table, but in the wild, the colors and patterns on a Blandings shell help them to camouflage or blend in, so they can easily hide in dark water with lots of plants. While Bob's shell is very dark, do you notice any bright colors on his neck or on his belly? Blandings turtles have a type of camouflage called countershading, so while their backs are dark, the bottom of their neck and underneath their shell is very light. This helps them to hide from predators in the sky, such as hawks or eagles, and it also helps them to hide from predators that might be swimming below. If a hawk or an eagle is circling above and looking down at the water, Bob's dark shell will help him blend in with the dark water below. If an animal underneath the water is looking up at Bob, they're going to see his bright yellow neck and the bright yellow bottom of his shell. This will look like sunlight coming through. So Bob is protected from the top and the bottom. Thank you so much for joining us. We hope you enjoyed learning about Blandings turtles. If you have any questions, you can drop them in the comments below. See you next time.